In this video, we are checking out what's new for Amp Designer in the latest release of Logic Pro. Hey guys, you're in the studio with Luke from guitaristiq.com. Thank you once again so much for joining us. We are staring at the brand new interface for Logic Pro 10. Specifically today, we're going to be looking at what's new in Amp Designer. Now, with this latest installment, Logic have introduced some great new features to their software. They've redesigned some old things as well. And just by looking at this interface, you can see that Amp Designer isn't one of those things, at least on the guitar side. Having said that, however, they have introduced a few new elements which will be definitely worth checking out. Okay, so just moving through this really quickly if you're not acquainted with this interface already. Up in this top tab, we have some options. We have a bunch of presets for clean, crunch, and distorted tones. There are tons of them there. In the bottom tab here, we have a selection for all the different models that are available to us. We can customize that further here by choosing different amps and matching them with the various cabinets. But for the purpose of today's video, what we're really interested in is this section over here, which we'll call, for lack of a better term, our virtual mic locker. In Logic Pro 9, we had three mics that were available to us, the first of which was this condenser 87, the second was this dynamic 57, and the third was this ribbon 121. Now, if you are familiar with microphones, you'll notice that these are obviously intended to be emulations of some classic mics that you would see in a lot of recording studios. To this collection, they've added the condenser 414, which looks a lot like the AKG 414. They've added the Dynamic 20, which looks awfully like the RE20 from Electro Voice. They've added the Dynamic 421 and the Dynamic 609, which again look like popular microphones from Sennheiser. All of these mics are known as pretty versatile mics in the studio and are obviously popular choices when it comes to miking guitar cabs. So this section of Amp Designer is obviously designed to emulate, you know, how it would behave in a real world situation. Obviously, condenser mics in reality are generally more transparent or balanced sounding microphones. Dynamic mics are generally cut more in a mix. They've got more happening, I guess, in the mid-range. Tone-wise, and ribbon mics are generally a nice, neutral, warm-sounding microphone. In positioning these mics, again, this is going to behave kind of like what you'd expect in a real-world situation. Obviously, the closer to the speaker, the more direct speaker sound we're getting, plus a bit of a proximity effect, which adds a bass boost in the low end of the tone. Moving it away, you know, we get, I guess, a less hyped sound in this regard. Along the other axis, we see the middle of the cone is going to give us the most presence in our tone, while moving it to the outer of the cone is going to mellow our tone out quite a lot. Great, so let's actually have a listen to some of these microphones in action. I've just pulled up a generic Fender style amp. As you can see, everything's set to roughly 6 or 7 on the dial. We have no effects and a touch of reverb. I haven't done anything crazy in the chain over here to really bring the most out of this sound. This isn't a mix tutorial. It's not about pulling amp tones. It's just about demonstrating some of these new features and listening to these new microphones they've added. I've pulled up a multimeter over here so you can, as well as hear what's going on, have a visual representation too. So here we go.
Thank you.
So for the purposes of comparing, let's just change the mic placement to the outside of the cone and take another listen. Well, there it is, guys. I hope that was able to highlight some of the new little features in Logic Pro 10's Amp Designer. This isn't really a review. If you're a guitar player and you do a lot of recording, chances are you're going to have your own third-party preferences when it comes to this kind of amp simulation software. There are a lot of options available. Have Logic 10 revolutionized the world of amp simulation? Have they raised the bar for developers everywhere? Have they done something crazy and new? The answer is probably not. Is Amp Designer a helpful inclusion to Logic Pro 10 for guitar players? Absolutely. You know, there's a whole bunch of presets, there's a lot of tweakability, these new microphones add a whole new set of sounds that you can work with. You know, if you're just demoing some ideas or, you know, wanting to get some stuff down quickly, this is great for that. If you want to get a little bit more out of your tone, as with any other amp simulation software, you can always add some post-processing, obviously, to help your guitars sit where you want them to sit. So that's what's new in Amp Designer for Logic Pro 10. Well, that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you are interested in more videos like this one, then please head over to our website, guitaristiq.com. While there, we would love you to sign up to our mailing list. You can also check us out on Facebook, like the page, leave any questions or comments for further videos. We'd love to hear from you guys, so leave some comments below. Please subscribe to the channel, and we hope to see you in the next video. Thank you.